Hey guys, welcome back to another video. So today I filmed this green look that you see here today. I recreated it from a look that I did on Saturday night, and this whole look was inspired by my nails. Because I don't know what it is about this color recently that I have been so obsessed with, but I like it. And that's that. But yeah, let's just go ahead and get on into the video, but don't forget to subscribe and like. And I don't know how, but this ended up me I'm not drunk, but drinking alcohol. I don't even want to tell you what day or what time of day it is, because that's embarrassing. But I hope you enjoy. So as usual, I'm going to prime my eyelid with my ColourPop No Filter Concealer. This is in the shade Fair 00. Okay, so to blend it out, I'm actually going to use a brush. I think I mentioned this once before in a video. When trying this concealer out, I wasn't sure if I had liked it, only because I tried using it or tried blending it out with my finger like I normally do. I'm not sure if you can hear my dog eating, but that's him eating. And I had said I wasn't sure if I had liked it, only because I had noticed when I would blend it out with my finger, it would kind of, instead of blending in the concealer, it would like pick up the product and just move it around. And the only reason why I had even bought this concealer was because Christy from Raw Beauty Christy always uses it and says she loves it. And then one time I was watching her video and I saw her blending it out with a brush, and I was like, maybe that's what I'm doing wrong with it. And sure enough, it was. Okay, so we're going in with three different palettes. I want to say four, but one of them, it's not really necessary, but we'll get to that later. But the first palette that I'm going to go in with is this. Hold on, because I put on this sweater because I was cold and now I'm hot and I need to take this off before I go crazy. That's what I was saying. The first palette that I'm going to use is the Morphe 35B palette. I know this was discontinued, so you don't have to use this palette. You don't have to use any of the palettes that I'm using, really. You can use whatever you want to use, but I was able to, I was gifted this before it was discontinued, so I still have it and I'm still using it because I really do like it. But I'm taking this green shade up here first, and then we'll be going in with this green shade. Oh, look at my nails. Look at them, but don't look at them. I did it myself, so they're not perfect, but like, I'm proud of them. I'm not sure why, but recently I've been really obsessed with green, especially like this color green, like lime acid green. I don't know what it is, man. Don't know what it is, but something about this color makes my heart sing. Just makes it sing. Okay, so on a really small brush, I never say what brush I'm using, mainly because I don't know what they are. Some of them don't have names on them, but this one in particular is a Morphe brush, and it's the M507, and I bought it because I've always wanted a really small little brush like this. I bought this one time, and also this one, which looks almost the exact same, but this is the Morphe 506. Why did I buy these? They're so, well, this one's a bit longer than this one, I guess. So I mean, same but diff. Then I also bought this one, which is still in the package, but it's the M562. And I'm sure I'm not the only one, but I have not used this because of the white bristles. I don't want it to get stained. I don't know. Moving on. So I'm gonna take that dark green shade and tap that into the crease. The whole reason why I am doing this look is because I had a this past Saturday. Today is Tuesday, so this past Saturday I had a quinceañera to go to. It was actually my cousin's quinceañera, and if you don't know what a quinceañera is, it's basically a 15th birthday party, but like on steroids. Anyways, so yeah, so she had her quinceañera, and I was wearing a black dress, and I wasn't sure what look to do that night. I was like, oh my gosh, I want to go dramatic, but also, like, I wasn't sure on what to do. And, I was like, I'm just gonna try to match my nails, you know, do a green look for my green nails. And this is what I came up with. So once that color is packed down, I'm going to take the other green shade from the Morphe palette and kind of go right on top, but also along the edge, kind of overlapping it. This is what is going to help start the blending process. And these are the exact same colors I used that night also, Sarah. So once that is down, I'm going to take the BH Cosmetic Take Me Back to Brazil palette and use these two green shades, just like mix them both in together. Ooh, that's a lot. Pretty much the same thing, just place that on top and overlapping that Morphe green. And then blend it all out. So I'm also going to take a bit of this darker green from the BH Cosmetic palette and pretty much again just go over where we place the dark green. So at this point, it's just basically going back and forth between the colors that you've been putting down. Right now, I'm going in with the first green shade from the Morphe palette that we put in. And I'm just going over the crease, just making sure that it is opaque. And then I'm going to take a brush, a fluffier brush. This has no additional product on it. It's just stained. But I'm just going to go in and kind of help blend everything out a little bit more. And then just with that dark green shade, I'm going to start filling in the lid a little bit with it. Now, to create this halo, or I don't know, I've seen people call it like a spotlight eye or whatever, I'm going to cut my crease. The same way that I've been using the makeup remover method, and on my little brush, I'm going to focus that in the middle. This eye might come out better than this eye. Fair warning. Only because I was trying to remember what I did that night, like the exact same steps that I did. I don't know why it always helps me to hold down my eyelids like this. So I can see better. I'm only drinking this because I was really thirsty. And there was nothing else to drink besides alcohol. I'm going to take my ColourPop concealer and on my little pad. This is so handy. I'm not even kidding. It's only like $3, I think. Or maybe got it on sale. I don't know. Either way, it's off. It's cheap. Now I'm just going to take that on my brush. This is also a Morphe brush. The only thing is, I made my boyfriend buy me this bite. Blah, 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 blah. I made my boyfriend buy me this. It came in a brush set. And none of the brush sets had numbers on them. So I'm not sure how you would look for this if you were looking for it, like, individually. But it is from Morphe. Just don't know what kind of brush. Okay, so now I'm going to cut the crease with this. Why did I make him buy me this? I think I won a bet. I don't remember. Or maybe this was a gift from him. I don't know. Okay, so now this step is almost unnecessary, but with every cut crease, I do this step only because I feel like it's just adds, I don't know why I do it. I just do it because I think it makes it look nicer. But basically, I'm taking this really small brush, which just so happens to be one of my favorite brushes that I have because it came in so handy. Whenever I got this brush, again, it's a Morphe brush. It came in a set also. I was like, I don't know what I'm going to use this brush for ever. But it's really it really comes in handy, especially when I'm doing cut creases because I like to take whatever dark color that I used. In this case, I'm using the dark green, the very first dark green shadow that we used from the Morphe palette, and I just take that right across the cut crease line that I make. But I like to do this before I put on the eyeshadow that we're going to use to cover the whatever area that we put the concealer on, only because if I happen to mess up, it's very easy to clean it back up. But yeah, so this is definitely one of my favorite brushes also. This is what it looks like in case you're wondering. Okay, so now. Again, back into that green, the dark green shadow. I'm gonna go over the edge of the concealer. I should have tapped this out first. So I'm going over the edge of the concealer in the inner and outer corner. And then with that second green shade from the Morphe palette, again, pretty much doing the same thing that we did in the crease. Just meeting in the middle. And then, I'm sure you've guessed it, back in with those two shades from the Brazil palette and then going right in the middle. I'm also like taking it right up against that crease. And this is what I was initially going to do. I was just going to leave it matte, like reversed up, but after this, I go in with a shimmery shade that I'll get into in a second. The edges are looking a bit rough right now, so I'm going to go back into that dark green shade again and kind of go over that. Probably have to come back to that in a little bit. But for the shimmer that I went in with, I used the Zulu by Julia's Place palette. And I took this green shade here. This palette doesn't have... Oops. Sorry. Okay, so this palette doesn't have names on it. I know a lot of their shadows or all their palettes normally have names for their colors. This one, I think, because it's white, it doesn't have anything. But I'm going to take this green shade here. And just on a really flat little brush. Yeah, super flat, super flimsy. I don't know. I think I got this from like Amazon or something. I'm going to take it on that brush and go right over the crease that we made. Juvia's Place shimmer shadows are unbeatable. Like, they're so good. And I'm going all along the cut crease shape that we made. I'm going all along that line. And then I'm kind of like dabbing it like in the center, smaller and smaller and smaller as we go down. And then just with that same little brush that we've been using, and go over the edges just to blend it out a little bit. Okay, so now for the unnecessary step. I just did this that night just because I wanted it popped more. Because I feel like this one, you can tell it is a little bit brighter than this one. So what I took was the Anastasia Moonchild palette. And I took the shade Lucky Clover, which is a green shade. And just on that same brush that we were using, I just like tapped it over. I didn't go too heavy with this because I just wanted it mainly focused like in the center. In the center, because this is pretty much in the center. There she is. Oh yeah, this eye came out way better than this eye. I think this is starting to hit me. Have a really late day. Right before this video, as I was doing this eye, one of my highlights in my Anastasia palette, like, fell out. I opened it and it literally just, like, flopped out. And I feel like I have shimmer, like, all over me. Because it was a blue highlighter. No, it's just, like, all over the place. It's, like, all over my legs. Everywhere. And I feel like that's definitely not the first time it has happened to me. Has anybody ever experienced that with Anastasia products? This is the second time it's happened. The first time, it was also pretty recently, my Renaissance palette. I fixed it, but I didn't do a very good job of it. But my Modern Renaissance palette, this shade, oh god, this is embarrassing because it looks like poop. This shade here like fell out and I was in a rush because I was leaving and I just really quickly like threw some alcohol in there and I was like whatever, and now it looks like poop. But this shade too, it fell out. This shade looks like it's about to flop out, but maybe, hopefully it doesn't, I don't know. But this one is the one that just broke on me. I literally opened it and it flopped out. When I got this palette, this one was broken. So I fixed it. And then this one came out. I don't know, man. Maybe it's just because they're so, like, soft. I mean, it's not going to get me to stop buying the products because I'm going to do my foundation off camera. And I'll be back. Okay, I want you to ignore my face because my skin looks terrible. I don't know what happened. The only thing I can think of is it's the primer that I used. I use a primer that I normally don't use. And my skin looks like, especially this area, looks disgusting. Okay, moving on. We're gonna do the lower lash line now, but I've already applied mascara because let's be honest, that's like boring. I'm gonna use my favorite lashes in the entire world. These are the Boldface Cosmetic lashes. The box is upside down, but the lashes aren't. This is in the style Alter Ego. I'm gonna open this son of a bitch up. Oh. Oh my god, I should stop drinking. Really quickly, actually, before I put these on, just to try to save my skin a little bit, I'm going to spray this hydrating coconut mist on by e.l.f. Hopefully that helps cover my eyeshadow. Do-do-do-do, where are my tweezers? Where are my tweezers? Hello, tweezers. Are you in here? I'm starting to panic. Where are my tweezers? While this is drying, I'm going to do a little bit on my lower lash line. With those Morphe shadows, I'm going to buff them on the outer corner. And then also on the inner corner. I'm going to mimic almost the same as the top eyelid with the darker greens on the inner and outer corner. And then I'm going to put the shimmery green in the middle. Okay. These lashes are just... they're better than anything in the world. Okay, just to finish off the lower lash line, I'm going to take... same green shimmer shadow from Juvia's Place. And I'm going to put it in the center of my lower lash line. And now, for the final touch from the eyes, finally. For my highlight. I said I was done with the eyes and then I realized I lied because I hadn't highlighted my inner corner. I'm just going to take the green shadow. I like green shadow. The green highlight from the Anastasia Beverly Hills palette. And pop that son of a bitch in the inner corner. Also, on my nose. Some people don't like colored highlight on their actual face. That is fine. I, however, love it. I'm going to use that same highlighter to highlight my cheekbones. It looks so muddy right there because I had a blemish that I was messing with. Ignore that. On my chin. On my Cupid's bow. Now for the grand finale. Lips. When I first did this look that Saturday night, I used this liquid lipstick. It is from Milani in the shade Adorable. This is my favorite nude lipstick of history. This goes with anything and everything. But I don't think I'm gonna use this. I'm gonna try this one. This is the shade Buffy from Lime Crime. And I'm not gonna apply it super neatly. In the center of my lips, I think I'm just gonna apply this NYX Lip Lingerie in the shade Satin Ribbon. And, ooh. So hot in the middle. Alright guys, so that is the finished look. I hope you enjoyed this green halo spotlight. I don't know, whatever you want to call it. Thank you so much for watching and being here. Thank you for being subscribed. If you are subscribed, remember to subscribe if you ain't. And see you in the next one.